What's up, Cardboard Nation? Welcome to another episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Hope you guys are doing well tonight. Thank you for joining us. I'm your host, Rob Bertrand. As always, this guy over here holding down the fort with me, Ivan Lovgren. How you doing, brother?
I'm doing great. I got lots of liquid, lots of hype, got lots of boxes to break tonight. Well, you've got them all. I don't get to actually see any of the product in hand, but it's going to be an exciting show. I was talking about it earlier today. Really excited for tonight's product.
Most definitely.
I mean, there's other good stuff. There's hobby talk, there's arguments, there's polls, but let's get into box breaks.
First off, congratulations to you on your personal Twitter account breaking the 10,000 follower plateau.
Thank you. It's an interesting scenario because now it doesn't show me when I'm close to a new plateau or not. It just shows.
Yeah, 10K. I know, right? Like, did you have to like follow half of those people to get to that number, or?
Well, so I've never used any sort of account aggregation with this one. But I follow a lot of people.
Just kidding, dude. you follow a lot of people.
Yeah, it's guy. I follow anybody whose conversation I like. You'd actually be surprised who in the hobby I follow that refuses to follow me. I'm like, I don't know what I did to them, but no, I follow people who create interesting conversations regardless of their feelings about me.
Well, yeah, no, that's still a pretty big bona fide following, so that's really, really cool.
Thank you.
All right, so we've got, as Ivan said, box breaks, of course, hobby happenings, part two in collecting the 1919 Chicago Black Sox, hot in the shop, Arizona Fall League recap video. But we kick things off with our Go GTS Live Cue of the Week poll. And for simplicity's sake, what we did is we really just retweeted a poll that I was running on my personal account because I was pretty sure I knew the answer to this question, but with all the current hype surrounding Zion Williamson without playing a single regular season NBA game, I just wanted to check the barometer of the hobby and make sure like it hadn't entirely passed me by. So the question is, you can't afford any, but someone is willing to gift you one. What's your choice? And number one was a Zion Williamson Silver Prizm BGS 10, an 86-87 Fleer Michael Jordan rookie and a PSA 10, a 2003 Upper Deck LeBron James Exquisite RPA BGS 9, or number four, a 1980-81 Topps Larry Bird Magic Johnson with Dr. J and a PSA 10. And I was right. Okay, I felt good after seeing these numbers. 78% still said the Jordan because I was a little worried. Only 3% went the route of Zion Williamson. Now, that could change in a couple months. This voting could definitely change in a few months. And I also had some people, you know, trying to finagle the question saying, well, you buy the one that's the most expensive, sell it, and then get all the others. No, it's a gift. You can't give it away or sell it or anything like that. It's got to stay, you know, in your PC. So which one would you want? Now, too many words to jam all that in, but I voted Fleer Jordan RC. I mean, you know, I'm almost not constantly, but trying to find one that I might be able to justify to the wife somehow. What did you vote?
It's like been literally used as toilet paper, but then slabbed, authentic. I'll use it. Was it number one or number two? It's a PSA authentic. I chose the Jordan as well, though. I'm also with the, I did have the internal debate of, well, the LeBron, you could just sell and buy the other three. Do we have time for a rant tonight, Rob? I was going to do it on a video later, but I can do it now.
I would love for you to do it.
Because you brought up something interesting, which is it's a gift. You can't sell it. And I had a really interesting experience that I was going to try to keep a little more personal. But my wife and I were talking about it this morning. That's how important it was. And it's really interesting to me, especially because of what we give away on the show, for example. I mean, I know our followers.
I think prizes are different than gifts, by the way. I just want to put that out there.
Yeah. And personally, I treat them. I treat a gift differently. In fact, I literally have a label maker here now because so many of you have sent me cards over the years. You know, you mentioned 10K. Well, it's been 7 years on Twitter that I now have a label maker to label the back of a card that I gift as a gift because I don't want to forget where it came from. And sometimes at the National, for example, you meet so many people, you get so many cards, you're like, you're in a spin, and then you get home and they aren't labeled and any of that. But I still also think it's interesting how we put that expectation on gifts and set ourselves up to be then disappointed if somebody doesn't behave the way we expect them to. You know, I take a very agnostic view towards the prizes on the show. First off, they're drawn by a computer, not by me. So it's at the end of the day, as long as you follow us, you can qualify. But, you know, when I see somebody selling our stuff from the show, I don't get upset. But I had a gift that the hobby community actually helped me with. You know, sometimes we do these things to do something big. And the recipient messaged me the other day and was like, yeah, so we're selling it because of XYZ. And I'm just like, it happened to me too, where I got all riled up and all like, gratitude, I want gratitude. And it's tough to just let that go. But you brought up gifting, and so it made me think about it because I'm constantly saying you got to let it go. And then it hit me with the whole like, no, I want people to be grateful. I want them to appreciate it. I want it to sit in the family for 45 years. And I was thinking about it, and I brought it up to my wife. And I don't know if I've mentioned this on the show before or to you before, Rob, but my wife is actually in organ donation. So she is a nurse, and she works in organ donation, which means people give pieces of their body to someone else.
Yep.
And she said, yeah, I know what you mean. And I said, wait, oh my goodness, I'm talking about cards. And my wife does know what I mean. But she literally, part of their preparing you to donate an organ if you're a living donor is a little bit on this is a gift. And the minute it's out of your body or out of your hands, how the other person behaves, it's their right at that point. So I just thought that was a little interesting that, you know, we sit here and we can complain about cards and gratitude and, oh, I sent you $100 card and then you sold it. But it's like, imagine, you know, there's still just cards at the end of the day. You know, somebody donates part of their liver and then 2 years later, the person they donate it to is drinking at the bars every night. Like, I don't know.
Yeah.
Anyways, I don't even necessarily have an answer, but just some perspective I wanted to provide on giving and expectation and all of that. And the Twitch chat is incredibly dead, so apparently this didn't resonate with very many people. Twitter chat is really high, so awesome. So provide comments, provide experiences, and this is a safe place to complain. I almost used a worse word. I forget if we're monitored by the FCC or not, but it is a safe place to share your frustrations. We do get them. I know sometimes of all people, I can be the one who tries to temper things and provide the opposite perspective, but I also feel your pain. I really do. So don't ever let me be not empathetic in the midst of my hot takes. How's that for a hot take, Rob?
Very
did we have time
good,
for
Ivan.
That?
All right. Before we dive into hobby happenings, please tell people why that Go GTS Live Q of the Week poll on Twitter is important.
Well, that's because we're going to be giving away so much stuff, no strings attached, as we just mentioned. You can do with it as you please. You can sell it, you can use it as toilet paper, or you can treasure it in your family for 40 years. I recommend buying a label maker if so you can remember it's your Go GTS Live card. But there's only one way for us to monitor and track all the entries for a giveaway. So wherever you're watching, whether it's Facebook, Twitch, live stream, YouTube, Twitter even, make sure you do follow us on Twitter at GoGTSLive. And that's why we put the poll there for you to engage with at the very beginning of the show. So you'll follow us. And then throughout the show, we'll be tweeting things out where you can retweet it to enter to win. Plus, thanks to our cool system, if you retweet the Periscope tweet that's penned, that is a live broadcast of inception of this show going on while I'm talking about it, it's very meta, you get a bonus entry. So make sure you retweet that one for a bonus entry. And just for fun, tag a few friends and tell them to get in and watch, because we've got over $1,300 worth of boxes to break tonight. No, $1,500 worth of boxes to break tonight. Almost $1,700.
I was going
to
say your math is awful.
I said over 15. I said over 15. That gives me a range, right? So, but yeah. So lots of exciting things going on here. And thanks for letting me get something off my chest. You saved me a Twitter video tonight.
Hey, my pleasure. Maybe Rexford will have a peaceful poop tonight. All right, let's take a look at just some quick news notes and nuggets in this week's hobby happenings. All right, so if you've always had an opinion about who you think should have a card in Topps, Allen, and Ginter, well,
always.
Now is the chance to make your voice heard. Topps is calling for all submissions via this tweet. As you can see, in just that 13-hour window, the tweet generated close to 800 replies, easily making it the most engaged hobby-related topic of the week. And also, a side note, a special thanks to all who commented that they'd like to see a card set or a card of Ivan and I in the set.
Like I said, toilet paper, keep it in the family 40 years, whatever you want to do with it. Here's something you definitely don't see every day. A 1930 Lou Gehrig signed New York Yankees payroll check.
Don't use this for toilet paper.
Yes, don't. I mean, again, depending on who you are, maybe. Right? Saw Mark Suster tweeting about sports cards today. No, God knows that guy could afford to use this as toilet paper. It's currently one of the featured items at Heritage Auctions. This is the very first Gehrig payroll check that Heritage has handled, and one of just a small handful of known surviving exemplars. Bidding is over $20,000 and ends tonight. What is that, a $2,000 check? $2,200 check? Mm-hmm. It's kind of crazy.
Definitely. Well, in completed auction news, Sports Collectors Daily reports, in their words, another T206 Wagner sale, another record price. The latest example of the most famous baseball card in the world sold for $1,353,000+ in Mile High Card Company's latest auction. The exact same PSA 2 example had sold privately for $1.2 million less than a year ago. The card has also been sold twice at previous auctions in the last 5 years, realizing over $657,000 through Leland's in 2014 and over $7,600,000 via Heritage Auctions in 2016. Hmm. So yes, for you math deficient people, the value of the exact same card has more than doubled in the last 5 years.
Well, a post on Instagram this week revealed that Topps may eventually be turning over the reins of the Topps Living set, not giving it up entirely, turning them over to a new artist. The artist currently responsible for the set's creation, Mayumi Seto, says that she will be fulfilling the terms of her current contract, but is currently unsure if she will renew her agreement with the Major League Baseball licensee. She cites several reasons, including the pressure of keeping to stringent deadlines, I can imagine with 3 cards a week, and even criticism of the artwork itself from collectors on social media that has caused her unneeded stress. Keep that in mind. There are real people that build these things. Nothing official has come from Topps, but we will keep you posted if anything further develops. A hat tip to Big Ben Shep at About the Cards podcast for bringing this story to the attention of the hobby.
Most definitely. Well, if you're looking for a quick, easy to read primer on, quote, investing in vintage sports cards, longtime collector Robert Jeffries has you covered. Suitable for both novice and experienced collectors alike, the book provides cutting edge analysis to identify value and purchase investment grade vintage baseball and football cards. And whether you have thousands to spend or just a few hundred, this primer will help you better understand the benefits and risks of investing in vintage baseball and football cards. It's available now on Amazon for $4.99 for Kindle and $9.99 for paperback. So very affordable. But wait, if you plan on buying it, do us a favor and use our affiliate link here on the screen, bit.ly/GoGTSLive.
If my experience is anything, that's worth about the price of a stamp if you do that. So, right, Rob? Like 39 cents on a $10
something
book?
I honestly don't even know.
Thanks, Amazon. But that said, it helps. Every bit helps. Drops in the bucket. Speaking of drops in the bucket, hey, have you checked out checkoutmycards.com? Robert? Audience? I don't expect them to respond. Yeah. Well, hey, ComC wants you to know that they still have plenty of positions to fill. They are a giant online marketplace for cards, and they are looking to fill several positions in multiple locations. So again, if you have ever wanted to work in the hobby industry, you have no excuses if you live in any one of these areas. Here's your chance. Visit the ComC job board at www.comc.com/jobs. It's that easy. Work in the hobby.
This year's National Hobby Shop Day event is scheduled for Saturday, December 7th. Now in its third year, the event has grown from 41 participating stores in 2017 to what we anticipate being 150 this year. Manufacturer and vendor support has been tremendous, with each participating store scheduled to receive over $1,000 in free benefits to be used the day of the event for in-store contests, prizes, raffles, door prizes, and giveaways. Presented by GTS Distribution, collectors will be able to locate a participating store in late November on the National Hobby Shop Day Facebook page.
Upper Deck is hosting the Sports Card Expo's first ever trade night at the extremely popular Sports Card Show. The event takes place on Friday, November 15th from 8 to 10 p.m. The venue is the Aviation Ballroom, which is right there at the International Center. And of course, in typical Upper Deck fashion, there will be raffle prizes. So come and trade and possibly win prizes. Admission is free, but you do need to RSVP at the event's Facebook page. If you have trouble finding that, see the Upper Deck Twitter timeline for easy access to that link.
Well, we know that many of you out there use the eBay Partner Network to generate a little extra scratch for your hobby budget. Well, you're about to get screwed. It seems the executive geniuses that comprise the current management team have decided your traffic isn't worth nearly what it once was, as apparently eBay has all the users, traffic, and sales it's need. Mm-hmm. It needs, rather. Oh, crap. E-commerce Bytes reports that eBay finally published its new affiliate marketing rate card, and feedback from participants in the eBay Partner Network program, known as EPN, indicate that traffic to the eBay site could be a casualty. Reason being is the disincentive to drive shoppers to eBay comes at a time when the eBay marketplace sales growth has been stagnant. Initial feedback from affiliates indicate many estimate a 30% or more drop in revenue under the new rates. One problem with the new rate card, they don't map to eBay's category structure, leaving affiliates to guess the impact of the rates until they're officially rolled out. eBay Director of Business Operations and Partner Success, Michael Lill, on the EPN blog said, many partners may see a small change in earning as a result of the new rate card. Well, Lil used an example of a Magic the Gathering box set that he said sells for $235 on eBay.com. Well, under the current rate card, partners would earn 50% of eBay fee revenue, which is about 8% in this case, or $18.80. But under the new rate card, partners would earn $9.40. That's a 50% decline in revenue and a much more than a small earnings change, Mr. Lil. So thanks again, eBay.
All I heard was that I really should have been into Magic for the last 3 years. Sports Collectors Daily has a new report. The bat used by Babe Ruth to hit his 500th home run has recently come out of hiding. allegedly tucked away in a closet for decades. It was gifted to Ruth by from Ruth to a close friend and remained in the family since the early 1940s. Now it will be the signature item in SCP's upcoming auction with a pre-auction estimate in excess of $1 million. Foremost bat authenticator John Taub of PSA DNA gave it the firm's highest grade of GU10. Provenance.
Game use 10. Well, and that's a look at this week's hobby happenings. All right. Anything you want to unpack in there before we dive into some box breaks?
So much I want to unpack. But I mean, I don't know John Taub from Jesus. Well, I might know him from Jesus, but I don't know him from anyone else. But I would love
hobby's foremost.
Yeah.
So my bad authenticator.
My questioning of this has nothing to do with him, but I'm just questioning. I would love to get him on the show to talk about how you authenticated that bat as that. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah, you look at the. I mean,
hiding in a closet
involved.
I know that there are, but I want to hear
an affidavit, photo match. I mean, it's all the same thing, Ivan. The story never changes. You know?
Yeah, but I want to see it. Because none of these articles that I've seen have had the actual details. They just say, "Oh, it was authenticated." So I just want to see that family friend stayed in the family. Did you ever watch that documentary that I told you about, The Forger?
I told you about it.
About the German guy?
I did. Yes.
You didn't tell me about that. I heard about it from somebody not in the industry. Specifically, told me about it.
Anyway,
unless you literally saw it on its German release and warned me about it then. Either way, okay, so you saw it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I think that that's just remarkable, that entire story, but how the provenance of those paintings were forged. Something that everyone in the hobby should check out. It's a German film called The Forger, a documentary. And the actual forger in it talks. He's the subject. It's like he loves talking about it. So, anyways.
All right. Well, let's dive into our live box break segment. We're going to kick things off with Topps Clearly Authentic, one encapsed autograph acetate card per box.
Yep. Most cards in this are based on the 2019 design as well as the 2019 inserts. There are some pretty cool exceptions to that, though, in the Clearly Authentic 1952 Reimaginings autograph. So they have the 1952 look. But remember, it's clear acetate. So whatever we get is going to be cool. And
rookie
we got a
Kyle
picture.
Wright.
Because of the nature of these cards, I need that held a little forward and close. Yeah, that would help too, wouldn't it? Illegal hands to the face. Okay, hold it real still, because that is fuzzy. Okay, cool, got it. All right. So, who does he play for? The Mariners, the A's, the Braves? What's going on here?
The Braves. Well, we could certainly do better than that with a second box, right? Come on.
Hey, there we go. There we go. Yeah, because it got real quiet in here real fast for a bit there. The chat literally stopped talking. Though part
much,
of it
much,
is
much, 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 much better. Daryl Strawberry, numbered to 99.
Oh, look at that green parallel. That's pretty looking. Nice. So that is a doozy. That's a fun collector card right there. Very cool. So do we want to give away both of the cards, or do we just want to give away the strawberry and put the other
we'll
in a prize
pack?
We'll
give away the strawberry.
All right.
All right, next up, Phoenix football. Two autos and a memorabilia card. Marcus Mariota, interesting choice. He's been having a rough year. There's my guy, Alvin Kamara. Davante Adams in a catching fire insert, number to 299. This is the regular non-parallel version. Taylor Rapp, safety for the Rams, rookie. Did he nice. Make the roster, Ivan?
Oh, yeah. He's good. He's good. Now the Rams themselves
Drew
are
Brees.
Dealing with some stuff, but
you know, Von Miller. Happens. Number to 149, Alexander Mattson, rookie running back for the Minnesota Vikings. And rookie defensive end autograph for the Green Bay Packers, Rashawn Gary. Number to just 25. Not too shabby.
Nice. Got it.
Julian Love, rookie.
Don't forget, you enter to win the hits by going to twitter.com/GoGTSLive.
Number to 299, red parallel of Marcus Mariota. Adrenaline Rush insert with Philip Lindsay. Dwayne Haskins, rookie base card. Jackson. Defensive tackle Jeffrey Simmons, rookie card. Wow. Catching fire blue parallel number to just 35 of DeAndre Hopkins. Andrew Luck, QB vision. It's weird to think he's gone. Christian Wilkins, defensive tackle. I don't think I've ever open a product with so many defensive linemen in it. I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing. Aaron Rodgers, Deshaun Watson, rookie running back for the Cowboys, Tony Pollard, rookie tight end for the Detroit Tigers, TJ Hockenson. Oh, we got a boom. It's a redemption, but it is a boom. RPS rookie auto jersey of Drew Lock.
Hold on. It's really having trouble focusing today. Can you pull it a little closer to the camera? There we go. All right.
Wow. Really would have liked to have seen that in hand, though. Dak Prescott. Jerry Hughes. Cameron Jordan, numbered to 199. Marquise Brown, catching fire. DeAndre Baker, rookie cornerback for the Giants. Jared Goff. AJ Brown catching fire, numbered to just 99. QB Vision, Patrick Mahomes. Rookie safety, Darryl Savage for the Green Bay Packers. Saquon. Mark Ingram. Is he good? Cornerback David Long.
I don't know.
The cut for the Rams. I don't know.
What is it, a 101? Oh, he's a Rams guy? I don't know.
I guess not. Number to 99, so...
He's no Jalen Ramsey, that's for sure.
Justice Hill. Cameron Smith. Number to 149, purple parallel of J.J. Watt. Memorabilia card, number to 75 of rookie Ryan Finley. Montez Sweat. He's in a funny commercial. Old Spice commercial.
Because of his name?
Yeah, Camaro. Rookie Josh Jacobs, running back for the Raiders. Tom Brady comeback insert, followed by Keneal Harry catching fire, Ryan Finley rookie base. So impressions of Phoenix design this year? What do you think?
I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing. But I can't tell much about the difference between last year and this year. But I liked it last year, and I like it this year. So I don't know how to compare the two. Sorry, it's only because you said this year at the end of what you were saying. I was just going to say, Impressions of Phoenix. Oh, I like these cards. They're shiny. They're cool. Good design.
They're very chromey. How about an Adrian Peterson number to just 75 parallel?
But I know, like, I'm sitting here with my PC stack, and I know I've got some Rams in here.
And Terry McLaurin, rookie wide receiver for the Redskins, closes it out. So
I had the craziest thing happen this weekend, Rob. I actually had time to sort cards.
Get out.
On the weekend. Yeah. Comp C, who we talked about earlier, is coming to town in 2 weeks, so I had to get some stuff ready. But
all right, so we'll give away the Drew Lock. All right, time to bring out some big guns with an SRP of $600. Impeccable 2019 NFL football.
Wow.
What's our box configuration here?
Sorry, I got distracted looking at the Patrick Mahomes injury. That's going to be lots of fun for everybody to go over for the next 24 hours. One pack, 8 cards, 5 autographed cards in a $600 box. So... on-card autographs from all the best rookies, dozens of on-card autographs from current NFL stars, and even more Hall of Fame autographs, plus one silver or gold card in every case. So a case hit silver card has 1 ounce silver bars, and then a gold card, I assume, has a 1 ounce gold bar, but I can't see odds on that. I don't know one in how many cases that is. And you can download a complete copy of the checklist at gogts.net.
All right. Nice little brick here. Thank you, Tracy, for hooking us up with some high end.
Yeah, that's pretty incredible of them. Hopefully we don't pull any Patrick Mahomes.
Todd Gurley, number to 75. beautiful autograph. Philip Lindsay, numbered to just 25. Man, I love the design.
Oh, there we go. Rookie running back for the Broncos playing right now.
Look, that is beautiful. Wow. Rob Gronkowski base, numbered to 50. About a dual patch auto of Bryce Love, numbered to just 75.
Wow.
Boom!
Good looking card.
How about a Josh Allen on card, numbered 25 of 25. Talk about good looking cards and a great signature. Thanks, Josh.
Yeah, full name. Legible.
Quadre Allison, numbered to 49 for the Atlanta Falcons. And I think he's going to be our guy this year. A lot of hits of TJ Hockenson.
Patch he's got a lot of fans.
Numbered to 75. So we'll give away the Hockenson, the Lindsay, the Allen, and the Bryce Love.
All right. And can I get the Hockenson one more time? And you've got a second box?
No, but there was a pack hidden at the bottom. And didn't you say there's only one pack?
So there's only one pack. I didn't get all the way through the sell sheet thing, though.
I turned around and I waited on my postage scale.
Did you only have two? Did you only have two base cards?
Yes.
Yeah. So there's supposed to be eight. Oh no, there is seven cards. Why did it say eight? Three base or parallel cards. So it might be a parallel. I don't know. Let's just open it. Let's see. What could it be?
It's thick.
Does it look like metal?
I don't think it's metal. Actually, does no, I do think like... it's metal. It feels like metal.
Well, use your eyes. Show us. Use
we
the
got a
on.
Case hit. Silver bar, Adrian Peterson, numbered to 20.
Wow.
Boom!
Oh, thank you, Panini.
Wow.
Just a reminder, you can thank them too. All you got to do is go on Twitter or Facebook and just say, hey, thanks, Panini. How freaking awesome is that?
It's got some nice heft to it.
And that's going to be like a 360 point, right?
Oh, yeah.
So are we giving away five cards out of that box?
I can tell you the exact pointage because where'd it go? I got my Ultra Pro dual tool here. Yeah, bigger than it's definitely a 360. All right, so yeah, Adrian Peterson, one. Bryce Love dual patch auto to 75. It's number two. Josh Allen, eBay 101, is number three. Philip Lindsay to 25 as well. Is four. And TJ Hockenson, patch auto. All right. Wow. So already we've given away a Drew Lock. RPS, and this is the yellow prime, so I don't know what the numbering is on that, but I'm sure it's pretty low. A silver bar case hit, numbered to 20. A Josh Allen, numbered to 25. A Ted Lindsay, numbered to 25. A Daryl Strawberry, numbered to 99. And a Bryce Love, dual patch auto, numbered to 75. Pretty cool. All right, we're waiting for NBA products, but in the meantime, we can still do a little Zion hunting. In 2019, Panini Prizm Collegiate Draft Picks with five autographs per box. an SRP reflecting the Zion Williamson craze at $300.
God, I don't even know what card to show. From so we got five incredible hits from that last box, and I can only put four in a tweet. Like, which one do I leave out? The Hawkinson, the Love, like
either one of those. Yeah, I would say.
Yeah, oh, I know, but.
But which one?
That's still a tough choice. It's crazy. Taking just a quick second to even look at some of these cards on eBay. That's over a $100 card right there. It's a $75 card right there. That's a $150 card right there.
Oh, you ready?
We got more. We got Prizm.
Yeah. Let's move on and do some Zion hunting.
Well, at least there's lots of base cards in these, so I can still oogle the internet for another minute and catch up on chat.
So we got an auto in every pack. Right off the bat, we've got the first Japanese NBA rookie player, Rui Hachimura in a Crusade design. DeAndre Hunter. Silver Prizm Chumi Oki rookie. Tie-dye Prizm number to 249, All-American DJ Barrett. Super Funky Prizm of
DJ
Grant
Barrett
Williams.
Or RJ Barrett?
RJ Barrett, sorry. Zion Williamson Crusade insert. Chuma Oki again, but just the regular base. And Corey Davis Jr. out of the University of Houston rookie. It's first auto.
What was the RJ Barrett number to? 49, you said? The tie-dye?
249. Jarrett Culver. Cam Reddish. Silver Prizm of Chuma Oki. Yellow Prizm number to 149, a Jordan Poole. You would expect this card to be numbered, wouldn't you? This different colored Crusade of RJ Barrett, but it's not. Brandon Clark. Wow. All sorts of photo variations, too, it looks like. Chuma Okiki again. And our auto is Romeo Langford. Silver
I like
Prizm.
The name. How about that Carson Edwards? You see that this week?
No.
Oh, this guy, he was a second round draft pick, and then he went off in the third quarter of a game and had 8 3-pointers in the third quarter of one of these preseason games.
Wow.
And his cards instantly like more than doubled.
Brandon Clark, Silver Prizm. And followed up by a Brandon Clark purple green Prizm number to 199. We got a green Prizm of Cam Reddish. Ty Jerome. And a Crusade of Cameron Johnson. And a green Prizm auto of Josh Perkins. I don't hear James getting excited about any names on these autos so far in my ear, so nobody's super great yet. Is that what I'm...
No, I mean, really, with this year, though, it's just like...
It's Zion
seems like Zion is everything, yeah.
Zion, Ja Morant, right?
Even Ja Morant, like, pricing-wise, is so much lower.
Romeo Langford, numbered to 299. Jordan Poole. Carson Edwards, there he is, speak of the devil. And numbered to...
Yeah, a Zion is literally five times what a Ja Morant is. Autograph.
Number to 99. What is this? Is this one of the red, white, and blues of Ignis Brazdeikis?
I guess I better screenshot that to have something to post. Come on. What? Come on.
Eric Paschal. Zion Base. Cameron Johnson's Crusade Silver Prizm.
Double check that that base is a base and not a prism.
It is a prism. Which one?
The Zion? No, the Zion.
Oh, yeah, it's not. You can tell. It's really easy to tell.
So, again, the Ja Morant Silver Prizm is $40. The Zion Silver Prizm is $270.
I won't even begin to pronounce this guy's name, but this card is numbered at just 25. Look at the prism action going on there. I think we pulled our... This has to be, what, guys? The 10th card of Chuma Okeke. I hope he's good.
Oh, Kevin orange. Porter Jr. What's that number to?
It's not.
Orange isn't numbered? Come on.
Why do you do this to me? Terrence Mann. And Green Prizm, Keldon Johnson auto. So since there's no Zion, no DeAndre Hunter, no Ja Morant, we're just going to give all those to one winner.
Keep in mind that Zion base is a $50 card. Even as a non-Prizm.
All right, so we'll give...
You said there was a Zion base in there, right?
Yeah.
Was there?
But that was, I think, our... How's the Zion Crusade? Is that any good?
$30.
All right, how about I...
$20, depending on the listing. Pull that up. They're going up, it seems.
All right, we'll give... What do you want to do? Hold on a second here. Let's just do this. Huh?
You told me
I just need one of our autos was numbered. How about...
Yeah, the numbered 99, right? The red, white, and blue.
All right. All five autos to one person. Both Zions to another.
Can I get the Zions for a picture? Back, actually, leaned back is good, yeah. There we go. Perfect. Thank you.
All right, time to bring out the big guns.
Real quick, before you do that, though, make sure, if you're watching, that you're going to twitter.com/GoGTSLive. And retweeting the tweets to enter to win these cards, because I want your full attention on this box break right now. So go do that real quick. Go to Twitter. If you're already on Twitter, I see the, wow, our chat room on Twitter is huge right now. That's awesome. You can also share within the Twitter, within the Periscope tweet. And yeah, this is Immaculate Collection NBA trading cards. How many Zions are we going to pull out of this one?
Zero, guaranteed. Because this is 2018-19 NBA. Worldwide debut box break. This product doesn't even release until tomorrow. And we have your first box break right now. what is this, a six hit configuration, Ivan?
Just getting to that. Sorry, I was making that next last tweet beautiful. Six cards, three autographs, and two memorabilia cards. So we're also going to pull one base in there. Now, of course, this is known for jumbo patches, huge pieces of memorabilia as some of the hits in here, including shoe cards. Would love to get one of those. Piece of a shoe, plus the rookie logo man autographs. Incredible one of ones. There's 40 of the NBA's top rookies from last year. Dual autographs. There's a Luka Dirk Nowitzki. We're still trying to pull a Luka autograph, so we could do that. And veterans. And I believe all autographs are on card. I'd be very shocked if we saw something that wasn't.
All right. Kicking things off. Damian Lillard base card, numbered to 99. Wow, look at the size of the swatch on here. Chandler Hutchinson, numbered to 99.
Ooh, Chicago Bulls.
Nice size patch. Miles Turner, numbered to 10.
Ooh. That's low numbering.
We have numbered to 99 for the Brooklyn Nets, Dazan Musa, RPA. Next up, numbered to 99, Mike Connolly. And we close things out with a boom, one of the best ever play the game, numbered to 25 with his numeral inscription. Ooh. On card, Reggie Miller. Boom!
And call me crazy, Rob. Wasn't that the big announcement with this product? Yep. He hasn't signed in how many years, right?
Exactly. Marks of greatness.
Hoo-hoo. Man, you had the hot hand tonight.
So we will give that one away. We will give the Miles Turner number to 10 away. We're going to find a Bulls fan and make them do something. Show us their collection on Twitter for that. But we will give this RPA away of Dazan Musa to the Brooklyn Nets. So three hits we'll give away. Two we'll find something to do on social.
Sorry, I was typing the Reggie Miller. What else was there that you wanted? What were the other
Dazan two? Dazan Musa and Miles Turner.
Gotcha. Wow, some huge hits tonight.
Okay, while you do your thing, we're going to dive into part two of collecting the 1919 Chicago Black Sox. Let me know when you are ready, James. Okay. No problem. All right, so we continue our look at collecting modern baseball cards of the eight players implicated in the infamous Black Sox scandal of 1919. That was 100 years ago, a dubious anniversary, or a anniversary for a dubious event. The plot's ringleader, first baseman Chick Gandel, was the one who directly communicated with the gamblers who created the fix. Slide 18 is the start of this. You good? Okay. The Beckett database lists Gandel as having a total of 74 cards with zero considered rookies, no memorabilia, 10 that are serial numbered, and he does have a one-of-one cut signature card, which we'll tell you about. But in 2010, much like Buck Weaver from last week, TriStar included Gandel in the Obach-themed tobacco-themed baseball card product. His short-printed base card also has four parallels with different colored ink printing in black number to 50, green number to 25, red number to 5, and purple number to 101. These kind of mirror some of the variations from the original OBAC set of his. In addition to the full-size card, there is a mini version, all of which have the aforementioned colored parallels. And then again in 2012, Gandel was also a subject in Panini's retro-themed Golden Age baseball card product. In addition to the full-size base card, collectors could chase four different mini versions, each with a different advertising back, as well as a black one-of-one parallel. But unlike Weaver, however, Gandel was not included in the product's insert sets. Nor was he included in the brand's sophomore release the following year. But one of the biggest card chases for collectors interested in the 1919 Black Sox is this one-of-one cut signature card produced in 2009 by In the Game for their Sports Kings product. Next week, we'll take a look at the modern era cards of the key pitcher in the fix, Eddie Seacott.
These are really cool cards. I don't know enough about that era. I glossed over that episode of baseball.
The collecting documentary. 2010, 2012.
Yeah, it's like a lose-lose for me because I really got back into baseball card collecting in 2014. Okay. And I kind of didn't start watching baseball until about 1988, so I missed both of the eras in discussion. No, but it's cool. I wish, are we going to do, is there a feature on the blog to go along with this to like provide additional context? Because I think that would be really cool because there's not a whole lot of stuff out there, I feel like, on those.
There will be once guys. We're done with this. This is why I threw James off and I probably should have mentioned something. That's why I'm the presentation is just going to grow in its entirety. And then we'll be posting it on the blog with a post and, so there'll be a master presentation when it's all said and done.
Nice. So just so you know, Pabst Beer 8 has already volunteered to show you his Bulls tattoo in order to get that Bulls card. However, since he's a Vikings fan, can he really be a Bulls fan? That doesn't work. It's not going to work for me.
All right, well, you better post that picture. And Ivan, if you can confirm, he will get that card.
Oh, okay.
All right.
I'll keep an eye out. It better not be in a spot I don't want to see, which is 98% of you, Brad.
So let's dive into a look ahead at next week's new releases hitting store shelves, online breakers, and your favorite online retail giants. Next week in Hot in the Shop, kicking things off, it's here. The bow tie on the 2018-19 NHL collecting season closes with Upper Deck The Cup. You know it. You love it. Two autograph patch cards in every tin. The wait's over. More great hits than ever. Close out that season with the biggest hits. Let's check it out. So, two autographed patch cards featuring one autographed patch rookie card from the 2018-19 rookie class headlined by Calder Trophy winner Elias Pettersson, plus one additional autographed patch card. New to the cup this year, super rare trilateral auto patch cards numbered to just three. Also new, a variety of rookie auto patch tributes numbered to 10, paying homage to popular rookies from the 2010-11 and 2013-14 seasons. More new content includes Splendor autograph patches and Hall of Fame 75th and 25th anniversary patches. Chase Rare the Show cards based on beautiful UDA pieces featuring some of the best legends in the game. Look for big-time booklet cards, including the highly sought-after autographed monumental rookie patch booklets, ticket inscription booklets, Legends of Hockey triple-sign booklets, and nine-way signature booklets. Also chase exclusive exquisite hits. Find exquisite rookie patch auto cards numbered to the featured player's uniform number. Always love that. Search for the elusive one-of-one exquisite rookie auto shields and hunt for NHL glory autograph cards limited to a mere 10 serial numbered copies featuring a chrome NHL shield embedded under an acetate surface with an on-card autograph. Also collect notable nameplate cards of your favorite player. Each card features a full letter patch from a game-used jersey, and you can collect all the cards to spell out the player's name. That's awesome, too. Grab superb memorabilia inserts like the Cup Trios, Quads and Sixes, limited logos, signature materials, and much more. And as always, keep an eye out for numerous unannounced Easter eggs. Let's let this play out because these cards are so beautiful. Going to be awesome. Hits next the 23rd, which I believe is Wednesday.
We've also got a much anticipated product coming out in football this week. The stalwart in many ways of the NFL season is Panini Prizm. Look at these beautiful, beautiful cards featuring the first NFL uniform silver Prizm rookies of names like Kyler Murray, Daniel Jones, Dwayne Haskins. Yes, all the top rookies from this year's rookie class. Credible new design for Prizm this year. Each box is going to feature three autographed cards plus nine numbered Prizm. Talk about a crazy packed hobby box of Prizm that way. One silver Prizm per box, so you know that you'll be able to chase those. But they've also got rookie patch autographs, franchise legend signatures, and plenty more content. Oh, including the popular Color Blast inserts falling one in every 10 cases. So those are a huge chase. Very, very
rare. Hey, we hit one of those.
Yeah, from soccer, we did. Incredible product there. And then, of course, remember, with these cards, keep an eye out for those shiny, shiny silver parallels, the silver Prizms. If you can't tell them apart, they say Prizm on the back, even if they look a little bit like a base card. This is coming out on Wednesday as well. You're not going to want to miss it.
Absolutely. Next up, a memorabilia product from Leaf, an autographed memorabilia product in the form of autographed football jersey edition. So one autographed custom football jersey in every box with an incredible mix of Hall of Famers, fan favorites, and some of the biggest stars in the game today, as well as hot young players. It's got a new lower price point and higher hit rate of the best players. So they went back to the drawing box, crunched their numbers, sharpened up their pencils, as they say, to deliver a better experience for the collector. Young stars and rookies, who are we talking about? Well, guys like Dwayne Haskins, Deshaun Watson, Saquon Barkley. Superstars, yep, Brady, he's in there. Rodgers, Breeze, Cam Newton, Russell Wilson, Gronk, Ezekiel Elliott, and Patrick Mahomes, check. Hall of Famers, Manning, Favre, Marino, Rice, Sanders, Elway, Emmett Smith, Dan Marino, check. And then legends, Walter Payton, Terry Bradshaw, Johnny Unitas, Bo Jackson, Jim Brown, and many more in each of those categories. Awesome.
And it's not only NLCS and ALCS time, it's also Topps Triple Threads time this week. Each box of Triple Threads is going to have two packs with seven cards. There's two different configurations, so that's exactly why you should use a site like GoGTS.net, is to know what it is you're getting before you buy a pack, so you know that you got all your hits. That said, each box should deliver at least one autographed triple relic card, one triple relic card, an autographed rookie card or jumbo relic card, and one additional jumbo relic card. This product features stars in the past, present, and future, while including all the high-end hits that collectors have come to expect, like those single jumbo relic cards, dual jumbo relic cards, triple relic cards, numbered to 99 or less. including rookies and hot stars like Shohei Ohtani. New this year is the 150 years of pro baseball triple player autographs. Get names like Johnny Bench, Mike Piazza, and who's that guy? Buster Posey. All on one card. Sorry, I'm bitter because they're talking about trading for him. The Cubs are. Rookie autograph cards with parallels, base rookie and future phenoms, autograph relic cards. Look for Vlad Guerrero Jr., Pete Alonso on-card autographs, and of course, some super rare cut signatures returned to celebrate the best to ever play the game, like Mr. Cub Ernie Banks, with those fun triple threads words spelled out in the die cut. Lots of fun, this product, every year. Rookies, stars. We haven't even seen the booklet yet. Do we have the booklet? Is the booklet coming up? Oh, three booklets coming up. And then, of course, the All-Star patches. This product always pulls some good content from the All-Star game. So you get unique, extra chunky patches. And as the slide says, it wouldn't be triple threads without stunning booklet cards. Windows into Greatness, autograph relic cards. There's also the triple threads, one of one game used nameplate bat cards. And of course, the super booklets with 16, 20, 15, 10, lots and lots of names, lots and lots of players, lots and lots of patches, bats, and pieces of material from the game. Triple Threads brings you closer to the game, and it's in hobby shops this week.
Awesome. Couple products from Super Break. It seems like it's been a while since we saw Pieces of the Past, and so here it is. Pieces of the Past Historical Edition delivers at least one Pieces of the Past unique one-of-one relic or cut card in every box, spanning the 1770s to the 1970s with people, events, and history. Look for rare certified signatures and collectibles from presidents, historical figures, conquerors, musicians, activists, actors, celebrities, and major sports legends. Find randomly inserted redemptions for JSA, BSA, PSA certified multi-signed and team signed baseballs, presidential signed documents, vintage signed photos, albums, checks, cut signatures, one of one the bar cut autographs, and scarce vintage certified coins. This product features Super Break's most historical and powerful subject list yet. Find certified cut autographs, inscriptions, and handwriting relics, the bar 101 cut autos, BGS slammed vintage tickets, game use certified sports relics, presidential relics, stamp relics, vintage book relics, vintage news relics, pennants, coins, and pins. Plus, look for single, dual, and triple relic combo cards featuring the greatest all on one card. Single and dual signed cut cards featuring presidents, sports athletes, musicians, and more. And be on the lookout for hot cases with 2 times, 3 times, even 5 times the number of items, as well as themed cases with and multiple redemption cases, meaning big, big hits await in Super Breaks Pieces of the Past Historical Edition.
So, Rob, this next product, I believe it's a carryover from last week, probably got delayed, but I had a little moment here to do some math. I talked about it last week. This is 2019 Heavy Hitters Series 2 from Super Break. Each box is going to deliver one premium buyback card. And you can see the cards there from the... Come on, graphic. There we go. Yeah, you'll see the cards here. Well, I had time to count just the cards that are shown. 23 different cards. Well, they have given us the case run. 150 total cases, which means there's only 450 total boxes. Which means you have over a 5% chance of hitting any one of these monsters.
That's pictured here, right?
Yeah, that's pictured here. That tells me that unless these are priced at $1,200 a box, which actually I don't know what the price is, but this is a pretty stacked product for a buyback product. So yeah, pretty exciting. Look for this in hobby shops this week from Super Break.
And last, but certainly not least, a one-of-its-kind, never-before-seen product from Topps, Art of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles trading card sets. Those crazy masters of martial arts on the half shell. Delivers one complete 100-card base set, plus one sketch card and one autographed card signed on card in every box, featuring 73 classic comic covers and 27 brand new pieces of art from Kevin Eastman, Jim Lawson, Michael Dooney, Steve Levine, and other illustrators who've been involved with TMNT in the past. So that's your 100 base cards. So the autographs, well, yeah, they're going to be of artists. No, Donatello is not like actually signing a card. So, but the autograph parallels of the base set include green, purple, orange, blue, and red. Bunch of different sketch cards include standard, shaped, and panoramic. So check this out. If you are a fan of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, this is all about the artwork. In shops next week from Topps. And that wraps up a look at Hot in the Shop. All right, folks, well, it's time to put Ivan to work to pull tonight's winners. But in the meantime, while he does that, our producer and technical director, James Gale, went down to the Arizona Fall League Fall Stars game.
Oh, I'm so jealous.
Put together nice video for you guys with some great content. So check this out. We'll be right back to announce tonight's winners.
Okay, we're here with, what's your name?
Parker.
Parker, okay, he's gonna open up some 2019 Bowman Chrome. And how long have you been collecting?
I've been collecting for about 2 years now.
2 years? Who is your favorite guy to collect?
D. Gordon.
D. Gordon, okay.
And we got Ryan Ricardo.
Okay.
And then Alejandro Kirk for the Blue Jays. We got Bryce Harper, limited edition of 499.
Nice.
We got Shohei Ohtani. And DJ Stewart.
So what's your favorite card in your collection?
Well, probably my Ichiro jersey card.
Okay.
That is also from Topps.
Oh, there you go. Nice. We got a second pack here. Let's see what you got. Who's your favorite team?
Mariners.
The Mariners. Oh, great. And who are you looking forward to seeing at tonight's Fall Stars game?
Pretty much anybody.
Sure.
I love baseball.
Yeah.
Robinson Ortiz, and then Austin Wark. Then a special tracker of Julio Pablo Martinez. Mm-hmm. And then limited edition of Kyle Muller 499, and Mike Trout.
Hey, there you go. Great way to finish it off.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much, Parker.
Thank you.
Bat boy for the Fall League. All right. And you are a collector. How long have you been collecting?
Since I was young.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who do you collect? Who are your guys?
I like collecting, like, Trey Turner. He's one of my favorites.
Trey Turner,
yeah,
sure.
He kind of inspires me because he's quick and, yeah, I like him.
Cool. And he's still in it. In the NLCS, right on. Yeah. So do you have a favorite? Do you like the more prospect-y products, or do you like kind of the more of the major league ones?
The prospect ones for here.
Yeah.
I mean, it's the fall. You get to see the dudes in the cards, and it's kind of cool.
Yeah, cool. So what do you got here?
Sean Anderson. Jose Devers. Oh, there's Pete Alonso, rookie.
Hey, there you go. Nice.
Tatis rookie.
Hey, not a bad pack. Not a bad pack at all. You do a Heritage Minor League just for fun.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
I've only been out there when I was in Stockton.
Oh,
yeah,
okay. Yeah. Anybody get anyone from here?
Yeah. Do you get into the online breaks, or you just packs here and there? Do you
every
buy
once in a while, I will. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, there's Royce Lewis.
Hey, there he is. He was just here a little bit ago. Yeah, nice. Yeah.
And then we got a relic. Fernando Hernandez, hey. But she's here too.
Relic.
Hey, real nice, yeah.
Out of 99. Evan White, he was here last year. Vidal, he's here this year.
Cool, yep.
And Gabriel Cancel, I don't know him, but that's right, a good pack.
Hey, yeah, no, two good packs. So you're Bat Boy here at Follies. Is this your first time doing that?
Oh,
or?
This is my second year. I did it last year, too.
Cool. And you're from the area? You just,
I'm from here, yeah.
Okay, cool. So any good Bat Boy stories? Or?
The other Bat Boy, pitcher was throwing in a ball, hit him in the helmet, and I was at home.
Oh, wow.
That was funny.
Do you get to hold on to any memorabilia from the game?
Every once in a while, I can get some cards signed and stuff.
Okay, cool. Yeah. And do you do the Fall Stars game or a bunch of the regular day games? Or?
A lot of the regular season games, and then this is my first time at the Fall Stars game.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Well, hey, thanks so much for talking to us.
Thank you.
How long have you been collecting?
I've been collecting since I was about 10.
Cool. Who do you collect? Who are your guys?
I used to collect a lot of Andre Ethiers and get them signed a lot. And then a lot of Jock Petersons. I'm a Dodgers fan, so I get a lot of those guys.
Cool. And do you you live in the area, so you check them out at spring training?
Yeah,
and then
I live in Chandler, Arizona.
So okay, cool. Yeah. And what do you got here? You got a pack of Bowman Chrome?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see what you get here. Do you like the kind of the shiny Bowman stuff or the retro heritage?
Kind of? Or like the shiny relics.
Sure.
So I got Eli White.
Cool.
Miguel Giraldo, first Bowman. Julio Pablo Martinez.
And that's the Arizona Fall League insert right there.
Yeah, and this is Brandon Lau. He's with the Rays now, right?
Yep.
And Juan Soto also.
Hey, there he is. Nice.
Yeah. That's a pretty good pack.
Yeah.
And
do you like more the prospect-driven stuff, or do you like kind of the Major League, the Series 1, or stuff like that?
I prefer the prospect stuff just because I work with them now
sure.
a lot, so I get to see them a lot. Mm-hmm. It's pretty cool to me.
How long have you been a Bat Boy?
This is my first year.
Okay, cool. Yeah.
And I got it from the other Bat Boy.
Oh, nice. Yeah. That's how you got the job. You were friends with him, and he helped you out. Cool.
Yeah.
And do you do the regular day games or?
I do most of the Raptors and Scorpions games. Sometimes we fill in for the Solar Sox.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. And so this is obviously your first Fall League game, or your first Fall Stars game.
Yeah. And so pretty cool. Yeah, it's cool getting to see all the guys in the clubhouse and stuff.
Right. Cool. Well, here we go. You got a pack of Heritage Minor League. Let's see what you got.
Got three guys for RBI leaders.
Mm-hmm.
Guy from the Blue Wahoos. Moises Gomez. Brent Rooker. And then some ERA leaders.
Right on.
And then Joey Wentz.
I like the color on that.
Yeah. The background's pretty cool. And some save leaders.
Very nice.
Yeah, very nice.
Nice little pack. Well, thanks for helping us out.
Yeah, for sure.
Awesome job, awesome. James. Yeah, very, very cool. We've got some funny behind-the-scenes stories that we can't share right now about that. Maybe one day, but good stuff. All right, Ivan, I got a whole bunch of stuff in front of me I need to mail this weekend. Who am I sending it to?
All right, well, you are sending it to 12 people. I've got 12 winners. Wait, 13 people technically because Brad did show up with a tattoo pick. Just goes to show why engaging in the chat is always good, because then we see things and we say, hey, yeah, if you do it, you get that card. So Brad did tweet us with a picture of his Bulls tattoo, only slightly marred by the Vikings tattoo. alongside it. But yeah, so Brad, congrats on that Chandler Hutchinson relic. You know how to claim your prize. But I've got 12 other winners here, and they may not know how to claim their prize. So if you hear your name called, you have to email us. Don't tweet us. Don't DM us. Email us at gogtslive@gogts.net. It's right there on the bottom of your screen. Email us your name, your address, your Twitter handle so we can verify if we have any questions. We don't usually actually verify, like have to take that step, but every once in a while we need a little extra step. And what was you won? Help us match things much faster and much easier. All right, four things. That's not hard, right?
One quick note, we did fix this problem with the email server that was causing you guys to get kickbacks. There's no forward redirect now. There's been a new account created tied to a different server. So no more problems with that. And two, remember, this past Monday was like Columbus Day or something, so no mail. So prizes from last week went out Tuesday morning. So don't be hounding us on where your prize is. It's running a day behind. They're coming. You know me. I'm good for it. They always come. All right. Where are we starting?
All right. So we're starting off with Topps Clearly Authentic Daryl Strawberry, numbered to 99. That's going to Captain Rico. Congratulations, Captain Rico. Email us to claim your prize. Next up from Phoenix, the Drew Lock RPS is going to Pit Pandemonium. Pit Pandemonium. Congratulations. I don't have an impeccable buildup here, especially because there's so many good cards. I don't know how to do them. So I'm just going to start in the order I wrote them. So the Josh Allen, arguably the big one. Going first, that's going to the J. Michael 86. J. Michael 86. Next up, the Philip Lindsay is going to Twitter user QCR28. QCR28. And remember, if the prizes go unclaimed, well, then they just come back into the pool for the rest of you that are actually watching at the end of the show next week. Next up, the TJ Hawkinson, big fan favorite there in Detroit, is going to StunGone7. StunGone7. The impeccable Adrian Peterson Silver is going to Brew Crew Jeff. Congratulations, Brew Crew Jeff. And then the impeccable Bryce Love is going to Ryan C. 07. Ryan C. 07. Switching up to Prizm, we've got two winners here. One is going to win all of the autograph cards. That's the Angriest Chad. Congratulations, Chad. You know how to claim your prize. I know you've been watching the show since near the beginning. And then the Zion Prizms, two Zion Prizm cards combined, is going to Biggie 2911. Congratulations, Biggie 2911. And then from the Immaculate product debut box break, the Miles Turner is going to Tony David 11. Tony David 11. The Jazan Musa, Jazanin Musa, the RPA is going to Ted Dastic Jr. And then that Reggie Miller numbered to just 25 is going to Steven 19868. So I know we've got a lot of Stevens that watch the show. Steven 19868. Congratulations. You are the winner of that Reggie Miller autograph card numbered to 25 from Panini Immaculate.
Awesome. Awesome breaks tonight. Thanks to Emily Kless at Topps and Tracy Hackler at Panini for providing tonight's boxes. A couple quick programming notes. Next week, tune in for some video content from Wizard World Columbus. And special guest, Getty Images photographer Dustin Bradford. You may not know him by name, but you know a lot of his work, whether you realize it or not. So tune in for that. So thank you for watching. For Ivan Lovgren, I'm Rob Bertrand. Thanks to James Gale behind the scenes. Be here same time, same day next week. And in the meantime, you know what to be doing. Always be collecting. Have a great weekend, everybody. We'll be back with a brand new episode of GoGTS Live, the Hobbies Web Show, next week.